Eddie LaVert out front. Chuck Buster. She used to be my girl. Shoo shoo doo doo.
This is none other than our good friend, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Woodard, aka the Doc. Again, Denny's pick. I choose who does the intros and outros of these episodes. And tonight happens to be the Doc. Had a great interview with him a couple weeks back. Very interesting man, very smart, very on point about a lot of things. I was very impressed, and we look forward to having another interview with him as well. So, again, I get to choose who I want. It's kind of like a new thing, and it's great because now, you know, I can highlight the Singsnap artist. Speaking about Singsnap, guys, I actually emailed the owner of Singsnap and I asked him to take a look at our programs where we highlight and feature artists and have interviews with them. So hopefully Trevor will take a look and you know, drop me a line saying yay or nay, Denny, good job, great job, horrible job, you suck, whatever, I don't care. I emailed him anyways because I'm associated to him on the network through LinkedIn. So anyways, I look forward to hearing from him. And so tonight we have a new highlighted artist that we are going to play a clip from. Her Singsnap name is Karen, and I've already started listening to a little bit of it, and I can tell you that I'm quite impressed. I've got to say, guys, that the talent, again, on Singsnap just blows my mind, and there's just so many artists, I haven't even scratched the surface of it. And then, of course, I'm going to go right into a highlight for the next episode. Some of you guys will like this, because I'm still waiting on some information about what we were discussing the other night in regards to the UFOs and stuff like that, which I found very interesting. Now, I did receive a text message today, so apparently sometimes when I upload the videos, and I'm trying to figure it out, but I have to adjust each video that I do, because what happens is sometimes it has restrictions on there that if I don't uncheck them, you won't be able to comment. So I apologize if you haven't been able to comment. And I'm still trying to figure out how to boost the viewership and everything else. So again, guys, if you can copy and paste the episodes that you like, put them on your recordings. Just copy the URL up there in your browser and just kind of paste it on your recording. You know, that will get a lot of people over to our channel as well. And, you know, I want to get more Singsnap artists highlighted and featured on here. And again, I just feel that a lot of people, everybody pretty much just needs to be heard differently on different platforms. And, of course, I always love to interview. So that would be your featured spot where I get to talk to you. Right? So it'd be truly an honor for you. I'm kidding. It'd be an honor for me. So, anyways, without further ado, so this is Karen, and she was sent over to me. And this particular song here, I believe, is one of the songs that she had requested that I highlight for her. And again, I can say, very impressive. So this one is a Faith Hill song. Now, I've never heard it before. However, I do like it. It's called Like We Never Loved At All. So let's give Karen a listen to. And guys, please comment, share this episode with your friends out there in Singsnap Land. And here we go. Let's give Karen her due.
You never look so good.
tear in your eye. Don't you have the slightest feelings left for me? Maybe that's just your way of dealing with the pain, the getting everything between our rise and fall.
Hey guys, you know this is killing me to not push my finger on the pause button and comment. I know I say I try to play it through, but technically I'm really not breaking my own rules because that would be a full feature. So where it's a highlight, I can do that. And besides the fact, I have to, as I do, comment on her singing, which I can say very smooth, very fluent. So what I'm trying to pinpoint is her vocals. There's another artist. I can't think of her name. You guys might be able to point it out, but there's another artist that she reminds me of, her style of singing, and if I think of it, I will say it. But nonetheless, I like the smooth carry she has with her tones. You don't hear a lot of strong transitioning going on, which is nice. Because some people, they don't need to really elaborate on that. It's just, again, I've said this over and over again, it's just a very smooth transition, right? So it's kind of subtle. And some people have a stronger transition where you can tell that their note is highlighted a little bit more when they're going into that change. And with Karen, it's just a very smooth transition. But at the end of it, it's almost like she's going into another note, but she's not. And that's what I'm hearing. She reminds me of this other artist, and I cannot place my elaborate brain on it. But let me play it, and I'll point it out, and you guys tell me. Right there. There.
Another week has passed, and still I haven't left yet. So tell me what your secret is. I wanna know, I wanna know. Baby, yet letting go like you did. Like you did, how can you just walk on by without one tear? Don't you have the slightest feelings left for me? Maybe that's just your way of dealing with the pain, forgetting everything between our rise and fall. Oh, oh, oh. Did you forget the passion? Oh, did you ever miss me at all to kiss me? Ooh. Ooh. Oh, baby.
I know who it is now. Not a female.
That's just your way.
Okay, so guys, I know the artist I'm thinking of, and it's a male, and I believe, man, you, what is the name of that song? Not Three Doors Down, Coldplay, I don't know. Anyways, so that's what her ending notes remind me of when I was pointing that out. It's pretty cool because it's almost like leave you anticipating because you think that it's going into another, almost like another verse, but it doesn't. It stops. But it's just the way she accents that note and closes it out. God, I can't think of the artist's name, but it wasn't a female. It's a male. It's more alternative rock. I'll think of it. But anyways, so I like that song. Again, I haven't heard of it by Faith Hill, but that is a very pretty song. I like how she did that song. I'm actually going to check out one more of her other songs here. Because sometimes you can really pick up on just listening to a couple of songs. This one here is called Spooky by Dusty Springfield. So I'm going to take a quick gander to this song.
In the cool of the evening, everything is getting kind of groovy. You call me up and ask me, would I like to go and see a movie? First I say no, got some plans for tonight, and then I stop and say, alright, love is kind of crazy with a spooky little boy like you. Always keep me guessing, I never seem to know what you were thinking.
So I can tell you,
and every girl looks at you.
Now there's no bio on Karen, I haven't read one, but from what my ears are hearing, her style, and again, I don't know, I haven't read any bio on her, but I would have to say she has, it's a older school type of voice, you know, I want to say an older jazz rock type of thing. I can definitely hear a lot of different mix in there. You know, some maybe some soul music, Aretha Franklin. You know, some of that old school style mixed with a little bit of contemporary with her own thing going on, but very nice, very smooth voice, and I'd really like to get her on so we can have a full feature with her to discuss more of her style, her upbringing with music, what inspired her, all the things that I like to ask, and just really pick a brain and see how close I am. But nonetheless, Karen, very good. Very good. So, Blue, definitely keep sending them. She was fantastic. We have another artist that she had sent to me as well, which, of course, we can always highlight that other artist. But nonetheless, I think that you know, overall, guys, just the talent that I've heard so far since I've been doing this show, it's so broad, you know, you can't say that one is better than the other because everybody has their own style that they bring to the music, which in itself is just unique, you know, and that's what I love about music. That's what I love about singing, as all of you know. You know, everybody has a this opportunity to express themselves with music and make it about what they're feeling, make it about their hurt, their anger, what they're going through, and just convey that into music, into some beautiful sound. So, which I think is really cool. Anyways, so we will definitely highlight the other artist, which, as a matter of fact, let me just take a quick peeksy here, guys. Let me see here. I know that. Okay. So this particular artist here, I don't even know if I'm pronouncing the name right because. Here we go. Glesgaman. I think that's how it's pronounced. Seven Drunken Nights. We're going to give him a quick little dabble here. Again, I apologize if I am not pronouncing the stage name right. Glesgaman. So, my apologies. Let's take a listen.
Oh, it's howling home on Monday night. The drunk is drunk to be. I saw a horse outside.
Seven
the
Drunken
door.
Nights.
Where my old horse should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, well, you kindly tell to me, he owns that horse outside the door, where my old horse should be. Ah, you drunk, you silly old fool, still you cannot see. That's a lovely soul that me mother sent to me. Well, there's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, but a saddle on a sow, sure I never saw before. And as I went home on Tuesday night, as drunk could be, I saw a coat behind the door, where my old coat should be. Well, I called me wife and I said to her, well, you kindly tell to me, who owns that coat behind the door, where my old coat should be. Ah, you drunk, you silly old fool, still you cannot see. That's a woolen blanket me mother she sent to me. Well, it's many a day I've traveled 100 miles or more, but buttons on a blanket should I never saw before. And as I went home on Wednesday night, as drunk could be, I saw a pipe upon the chair, where my old pipe should be.
Now, I've never heard this song before, which is actually pretty cool. And I like stuff like that, man. I like the Irish music and stuff. As a matter of fact, years ago when I was a DJ, I used to DJ in this club one, you know, a couple cities over. It's called J.P. McBride's years ago. And boy, man, I'll tell you, they were Irish, as Irish can be. You know, but it was cool though because I used to always get all these free sandwiches. They had great food, great atmosphere, and man, they could drink. Oh boy, I'll tell you, these people that came down to this pub, they were drinkers. But I play a lot of the Irish music and stuff. A lot of it's pretty cool. Like I never heard of half the stuff that these guys had requested me to play. And I, you know, I had the music. I pretty much had everything and anything under the sun at that time. But if I didn't, I got it. But anyways, nonetheless, a lot of it was really educational for me because I got to learn a lot of history on different ethnic backgrounds on music and musicians and stuff. And they actually had somebody come in and play the bagpipes, so it was pretty cool. Scotland and all that stuff, you know. Anyways, I just had to throw it out there. That's what that reminded me of. So we'll get more on him as well. I like that. That was really a cool song. Definitely a change up. So thank you very much, my friend. And in here he says a wee bit of the Blarney, if I'm reading that correctly. Must be an Irish thing. Scottish, Irish, Scottish, kind of the same thing. I don't know. I do not know, but I'm sure I'll find out. All right, my friend. Okay, so moving on here. Yeah. So, guys, next show. This is really cool. And like I said, I'm still waiting for information that I reached out to this society, I suppose, if you will, where they investigate and do all bunch of fun things when it comes to paranormal. They're more geared towards UFOs and stuff like that. You know, lights in the sky and unexplained objects and stuff. And so I kind of reached out for them, asking them several questions. And I would like to get them on the show to pick their brain. So we will see what happens. So the next show, which is going to be cool, because this here, which I'm sure a lot of you are, I can tell just by some of the emails I received, especially one in particular, are really intrigued by the dead, spirit world. And I have a whole thing on it. What I can tell you is that you may be shocked to learn that perhaps the things that you think are fun and innocent just may not be so fun and innocent. And what I will share with you is all factual, and it's all scripture based. I don't make anything up. I don't assume anything, and I go off. Of course, when I share stories with people, it's based on my own experiences. And then, of course, when I share facts and information, that's exactly what it is. It's straight from the source itself. A lot of times when I read articles and stuff like that, I try to go to a trustworthy source so that the information I am passing on is as reliable as it can get, all right? So that's going to be cool, guys, because it's going to be Are the Dead Alive? And I think you'll find it quite interesting. So we actually do a couple of episodes on that because it's very in-depth. My little princess, Xena, you guys might remember her, a little black cat I had. Well, she's getting a little bit bigger, not bad. But anyway, she just walked by and scared the living daylights out of me. And then what I also wanted to discuss, which I thought was really cool. All right, guys, listen. Here's the thing. Affirmations. I've been doing a bunch of research on it, and I know I've spoken about this. Now, affirmations, in my opinion, they're not bad. Okay? They're not a cure-all, in my opinion. I personally know a lot of people who, that's all they do is affirmations. And again, to understand the affirmations and to really find out the science behind it, practicing positive affirmations can be extremely simple. And a lot of times, all you really need to do is pick a phrase and repeat it to yourself. That's how it's taught. So in other words, thinking that you're great. Now, there's a difference, right? So the affirmations, they're not, it's not a bad thing. I'm not saying that people who do it are bad or anything like that. No, by no means. But what I'm saying is, some people feel and believe that just by thinking it, things materialize or things just happen. Now, when we discuss this in the coming soon episodes, what I'm going to discuss and back up with what I'm explaining is that the positive thinking, yes, great, fantastic, I encourage that all the time. However, to wishfully think that things materialize, such as there are people who honestly believe if they keep thinking hard enough and they repeat it every day, say whether it's money or wealth or what have you, that it's just going to somehow happen. Now, the differences are very simple. That when you believe in something strong enough and you're setting your mind to accomplishing a certain thing, then yes, 9 out of 10, you're directing yourself in that path to where it is you need to go, right? And 9 out of 10, you will meet up with people or talk to people or find yourself in situations because you're putting yourself in situations because you want something so bad that now you have surrounded yourself around the very things that you're wanting to happen, right? So that's not a bad thing, and that's not like a magical thing where you're just sitting at home on your couch every single day just wishing for financial freedom. Now, I think that that's a little different than what we're going to discuss, okay? So I just want everybody to be aware of that. So positive affirmations, they require regular practice. If you want to make lasting long-term changes, the way that you think and feel, the good news is that the practice and popularity of positive affirmations are based on widely accepted and well-established psychological theories. So it's not like people are going mental, but there's a reason why these affirmations have picked up such strength and such traction. And then I'll explain that as well. There's a reason behind the popularity of these. And it's not that far off as to some of the other things that I discussed in the past about positive thinking. And repeating the fact that, I could tell people, when you wake up, say out loud, you're going to have a great day. Today's going to be a good day, right? That's an affirmation. So it's not that far off. It's just I'm going to explain the differences in what people just need to be careful of and or watch or what you believe. And don't fall victim. Many people do. Don't fall victim by paying money to certain programs or these YouTube ads that they have for people promising you that, oh, if you pay X amount of dollars, you're going to become wealthy. You're going to do this, that, and the other. Please don't do that. I have seen so many people do that. Please don't do that. Okay? Do your research. Be smart about things. Okay? And together, we can show you how to do the correct way of doing positive affirmations. It's really no different than thinking positive and actually putting action behind your positivity, behind your positive thoughts. So these are the episodes we got coming up, guys. Are they dead? Positive affirmations. And of course, I'm waiting to hear back from these people who do UFO stuff. That's going to be cool. And again, I hope to get them online. And if you guys have stories that you want to share with me, by all means, if you're on Singsnap, get in touch with Blue Opal. She will then, of course, pass that information on to me. I would love to talk to you guys, love to interview with you guys. So, guys, for now, I wanted to do a quick little thingy. And hopefully, we can get... Yes, we can get Karen. I'm going to hopefully have Doc back on. I'm going to have Arjun back on so that we can discuss and talk about different subjects, different topics of interest. And, you know, guys, we're just here to have fun. We're here to inspire. We're here to help people get out there who really want to share their stories. I'd love to hear them. So for now, I'm your host, Danielle Curtis. As always, be kind to others. Be kind to yourself. Okay? Take care, guys. God bless. I will see everybody soon.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, all our troubles will be out of sight. Have your